Presenting physical products online in an interesting way can be challenging, especially if you don't have great video footage or great lifestyle product photos. But today I'm going to show you how to take simple product shots and turn them into an engaging and stylish video animation that you can use online, whether it be for websites, social media, or even for advertising. And we're going to do that just using Canva. The first thing I want to do in preparation for creating this animation is to create a background and then put the products on that. So I'm going to start by using a video, and I'm going to use a YouTube video. And the reason I'm doing that is because I want a wide artboard to work on. So you could use any kind of document layout like this, but I want to create an image that's quite wide from left to right. So this makes it easier to see what I'm doing. So the first thing I want to do is go to Photos, and I'm going to search for a light wood texture. And this is what I want to use as the background to kind of layer my products on. So I'm going to scroll down until I find one that I like, and I'm going to bring that into the document. Now, if you can find one that stretches wide left to right and still looks in proportion, that's great. But for me, I'm going to have to create a little bit of a pattern, basically. So I'm going to scale this down, and then before I start duplicating this to create a pattern, I'm going to go to Edit Photo, Adjust, and I'm going to take the contrast down. And when I slide this down, you'll see the image loses a little bit of the definition or the contrast between lights and darks. And that just helps sometimes to make the product stand out from it a little bit. Now, what I'm going to do is zoom in a little so you can see. And now I'm going to duplicate this to the right-hand side of this image to try and create a wider pattern. You'll see that there's a very definite line where these join. You can see that the colors don't quite match up. And the way to get around that is just to click on one of them and flip it horizontally. Now they basically reflect each other, and so it looks like it's one consistent flow of that image. I'm going to then do the same with both of these and bring it down. And you'll see you have the same thing where they don't quite match up. So I'm going to flip these vertically so that they reflect each other, and just resize slightly so the plank sizes look all right. So that's the start of my pattern. If I zoom out, you'll see I'm going to then duplicate all four of these and follow the same process of just spacing them alongside and continue to do that a couple of more times until I have a very wide background to place my products on. So once I'm happy with that, the next thing that I want to do is to bring in my products. Now I'm going to use some t-shirt designs that I'm actually thinking of selling. In my uploads, you'll see I've uploaded these 5 t-shirt images. I'm going to bring these into my document so that all 5 of them are in here, but they have a background on, and I want to remove that so that they look like they're on this background I've just created. I'm going to do that for each one simply by going to Edit Photo and Background Remover. And then you'll see it takes away that background that I have on each of them. At the end of that, I am left with 5 images of t-shirts with no background. So I'm then going to resize these so that I can spread them across this background that I've created. And I'm going to leave a little space on the left and a little space on the right so that I can add some other elements like text, etc. at the beginning and end of this ultimate animation we're going to do. The next thing I'm going to do is arrange these so that they look interesting. And I'm going to give a bit of space between each of them, and I'm going to change the angle of them a little so that each one is a bit different and adds a bit of interest to the overall flow, which is what I call artistically scattered, which basically means I just stick them on a page and mess around with them until they look okay. Once I'm kind of happy with how those look, just make sure that I've kind of got them centered and I'm happy with that. The next thing we want to do is select all of them, which you can do just by clicking and dragging on the artboard and selecting all of those elements, and then either clicking Group here in this button that pops up or Control G. And now that whole element is one group, which we can essentially treat like one image. Now, once we've got that, we're going to actually create the artboard or the frame that we're going to use for our animation. But before we start that document, we're going to select this group again, and we're going to hit Command or Control C, which copies it. Then we're going to go to the home of our Canva, and we're going to create a new video. I'm going to use a Facebook video because It gives us a square proportion and is the most useful for using on the grid or for an advert. But you could, of course, do this using an Instagram reel size or any other size that works for where you want to use the video. Now, the next thing we're going to do is we're going to just hit Control V or paste, and we're going to paste that group into this document. And then I'm going to use the little zoom on the bottom right here of this video document. I'm going to zoom out so that I can then click on the group and drag it to resize it to fit this artboard. I'm actually going to make it a little bit bigger than the artboard, top and bottom, so that there's a little space for us to play with. But essentially, this is now a single image, which is running off the page. I'm going to zoom back in, and then I'm going to move the whole group so that it's evenly spaced and move it to the right so that I've got some space to add initial text. I'm just going to add a simple text box in, and I'm going to use a bold font, and I am just going to say a new collection, and I'm going to increase the size of that, left align it, change the spacing, and then I'm going to change the color to white. I want it to stand out from the background a little more, so I'm going to click on the text, go to effects, and choose a lift, which adds a little bit of a subtle drop shadow behind it. The intensity I'm going to increase a little bit more so that you've got some depth, and that's basically all I'm going to do on this first page. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to copy and paste this whole page that you see in the timeline here. I'm going to adjust the timing to about 3 seconds, and then I'm just going to click on it, going to copy and paste. And then for this slide, I'm going to delete the text because we don't want it on the next version of this. But what we do want is we want this image to move along to showcase this first t-shirt fully. I'm going to move it along, move it up a little bit. And now that is the feature of this slide or this part of the animation. The next thing we're going to do is duplicate it again. And we're going to move it along to showcase this t-shirt. And we're going to just repeat that until we have done this for all of the t-shirts and we make sure that each one has its moment to shine and so people can see the whole range that we are showcasing. And then at the end, I'm going to slide it all the way along, leaving me space to add some text again. I'm going to copy and paste the text from the first slide and I'm going to just change it to shop now. And what I want to do is to just add a little element in here that so that they know where to go. I'm going to go to elements. I'm going to type in search bar and I'm going to use this graphic underneath the words and then add in a text box with the domain that you want them to go or where they can find your shop. Move that down so that it's on the actual search bar. And then what I'm going to do is just change the letter spacing a little so that it's clear to read. And I'm going to add in a typewriter animation so it looks like it's being typed in. And that's basically our final slide. If we go back to the first slide and we scroll along or play, you'll see that currently it just very quickly jumps to the next slide and that doesn't look very natural. So what we're going to do is we are actually going to click between one of the slides, click on Add Transition, and we're going to use this very helpful match and move effect that Canva has built in. I'm going to increase the duration so that it's a little slower, and then I'm going to click Apply between all pages. If we play this now, you'll see that we have already created a really super stylish video that smoothly animates and shows us this whole range of t-shirts and really showcases what they look like in a more interesting way than just having a typical photo slideshow. But we can take this one step further. We can add a few more elements that add interest. So for this page, I think what I want to do is I am going to go to elements and I'm going to type in coffee and then I'm going to choose cutouts only. And I'm going to choose this one here, which is a coffee mug. And it's even got a nice little shadow on it, which really does make a difference and adds a lot of depth to your images. Then I'm going to scale it down so that it looks sort of right in proportion to the t-shirts. And I'm actually going to lay it over the t-shirt a little bit. I want to create a bit more of this kind of effect so that it looks like you're looking at a flat lay photo. So I'm going to type in flat lay book. I'm going to use that one, which is a nice little black notebook. Again, scale it so that it's in proportion. And I'm actually going to put it behind the text a bit. And then the last thing I'm going to do is I'm actually going to search for pen. And we'll just use this black and silver pen here. and scale it, and I'm going to put it over the book. Now, that would look a bit weird over the text, because it means that it's in front of the text, but the book is behind, so I'm just going to go to a position, and I'm going to click and drag that layer to behind the text, so that the pen itself isn't actually in front of the text. Before we go through the rest of the video, I just wanted to remind you that the pre-sale for my upcoming Canva course opens on Monday. I'm really excited about this course because not only does it show you how to create stylish designs in Canva, it also teaches you how to create your own system and process and workflow so that you can create in Canva confidently and without any overwhelm. The course is focused, it's really practical, and honestly, I haven't seen a course with this kind of approach to using Canva. If you'd like to join us and that sounds like something that would be useful to you, then please go to the link in the description below the video or in the link up here in the corner and you can sign up to be on my list. People on the list for pre-sale will be offered a huge discount and that will only be available for 1 week before it goes up to the normal price. I will also be creating part of the program based on input from people who are on the pre-sale list or buy during that period, so that I can make sure that you get exactly what you need to succeed from this program. Right, enough of that, let's get back to the video. So that's kind of cool, we've got some interesting elements, but if we now play, they just disappear at the end of this slide. So what we want to do is we want to add a bit more motion. So I'm going to start with the coffee mug, I'm going to copy it and paste it onto the second slide, and I'm going to move it off. So I'm going to angle it slightly, and I'm going to move it off to the left-hand side. And what that does is it adds the match and move animation that we've already applied, so that you'll see when I play it, it's a really cool smooth transition as it exits the page. And I'm then going to do the same thing for the book and the pen, just having them move to different positions. So the book is going to fly off the top of the screen, and the pen I want to fly off in a different direction. But if I can't select the pen because the text is over it, I can just go to position, click on the layer, and then copy the pen from there. Go to the next page, paste it, and I'm going to turn the pen right around and I'm going to have it flying off to that side. Now, I've talked about this match and move animation in previous videos, so I'll link to one of those up here so that you can go and have a look how it works if it's new to you. But basically, it adds in the animation frames for us, which is a much easier way for us to create these animations very quickly in Canva. So once I've added that in, if I play this video now, you'll see how these elements I've introduced on this first slide or page transition off using that match and move animation. And it just adds great movement and is really fun. And you can then go through and add elements to each of these pages if you wish. Obviously you don't have to, but it's a really cool way of adding some depth. Just make sure that you use cutouts and you remember that this is something that you're looking at from above. So you ideally want things that are shot directly from above. Once we've added our elements in, we're pretty much ready to have a look at the final product. So I'm just going to hit the play button at the top, and this is what our animated video looks like. We've added some elements in that move, but essentially we're showcasing the product and just adding a little depth. And as I mentioned, anything that can be photographed against a plain background can be used with animations like this. There are so many variations of this kind of carousel or animation that you can create in Canva to really bring your products to life. But I don't want to create too much of the same thing for you, but if you'd like a few more of these examples with different styles and different products, please just drop a comment below the video and let me know, and I will make sure to add those to the videos that I'm creating. Thank you, lovely humans. Have a fabulous week, and keep an eye out for my email that'll be in your inbox on Monday.